Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining our first webinar on solidarity and responsibility of business in response to COVID-19. Before we start the official webinar and the program you already received, let's go through a little bit of technical information. I know it's hard and I know it's the first day of the week, but still we are in an online environment, so we have to adapt further. That is why let's look at the technical and digital rules of our webinar. First, of course, you will be on mute to minimize the audio noise, as you may see that the event is recorded during the whole time. Second, if you have any technical problems, please refresh the link and log again. And I think that everything will be solved by then, or check your internet connection. You cannot see the participants and the presenters, but what you can see will be their presentations. During the presentations, all the questions that have risen in your mind, you can just publish in the questions and answer section, not to forget them. And then during the question and answer session in the end of the webinar, we will be able to answer them thoroughly. Last but not least, if you have any other further questions, you can use the email for contact information. Later on, you will have all the presentations sent to the mails you already registered with. And then I think that later, all the Sofia University students who already registered will be able to listen to the presentations from this webinar. Thank you very much, and let's continue. So what is going to be the agenda for today? We have a welcoming words and the role of responsible university presented by Mr. Professor Atanas Gheorgheev, who is the Dean of the Faculty of Economic and Business Administration, our kind host for today's webinar. Then we will listen for Dr. Skender Sila, who is the World Health Organization representative of head of the country office in Bulgaria, speaking on the business and protection of public health. Later on, we will hear on Jane Muita, the representative of UNICEF in Bulgaria. She will discuss with us how business can help to reduce the impact of COVID-19 on families and children, which are one of the most vulnerable in the present situation. Last but not least, we will be able to listen to Mr. Brankov, who is a vice president of the Bulgarian Industrial Association, to present us the viewpoint of business as a force for good during the period of crisis and the period of recovery, the more important one. In the last 20 minutes, we will be able to have your questions and answers, and I hope you will be ready to participate actively in the last part of our meeting. So let me give the floor to Mr. Associate Professor Atanas Gheorgheev, who is Dean of FEBA in Sofia University, as well as head of the Department Industrial Economics and Management and director of the master's program Energy Markets and Services. He's an energy economist with PhD dissertation on the institutional interdependence of energy regulator authorities, and has master degrees in energy economics and finances and banking. Atanas is a board member of the National Committee of Bulgaria for the World Energy Council and the Electric Mobility Industrial Cluster. He has also worked as a consultant for restructuring in the energy sector in Bulgaria. So please, Mr. Gheorgheev, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Marina. Hello, everyone. I don't know if you can see my screen.
Not yet.
Okay, maybe now.
Yep.
So welcome on the virtual grounds of Sofia University. I'm very glad that the Faculty of Economics and Business Administration, even in these very difficult times, could be hosting such interesting and important events with our partners. I would like to thank Marina for the organization of this webinar, and of course our panelists, our guests today, who are going to discuss the topic about solidarity and how we are going to overcome the difficult situation together. So, just a few words in the beginning about our university and faculty and what we have done in the past 2 months. For some, it has been a long time. For us, it was very dynamic. So, it was like yesterday that everything started. So our university, it's well known that it's the oldest university in Bulgaria with 16 faculties. We cover basically the whole field of sciences except for engineering faculty. But of course we have some engineering majors in our other faculties as well. So it has been a real challenge to react to this crisis with such a diverse community, but we'll get much more into that further. Just wanted to mention here that our university has about 3,000 employees and more than 23,000 students currently, which makes it also the biggest institution, academic and research one in Bulgaria. About our faculty, we should have been celebrating our anniversary this week. Actually, the Faculty of Economics and Business Administration was founded 30 years ago, and it was re-established in the structure of Sofia University after many years without an economic faculty in it. So in 1990, the faculty started its work on the 16th of May. Again, this week is an anniversary one, so we can even say that this event is part of it. And we are ranked first in the economics field. We have 3 bachelor programs and more than 20 master's programs. And we teach in Bulgarian, English, German and French language. As we also accommodate many international students, more than 50 each semester, and we also have many visiting professors and exchange on the Erasmus program and on bilateral contracts, which is also not quite possible now in the terms that we have been accustomed to. So I would like to stress here that our faculty has been a member of the community of responsible organizations in Bulgaria and following the principles of sustainable development. As you can well see here, we're a member of the UN Global Compact and the Bulgarian Network, the Prime Initiative of the United Nations. This is the Principles of Responsible Management Education Initiative, which includes the best management universities in the world. We are also very active in other clusters and local associations, and we also have very interesting initiatives with them. I decided to stress on the role of the responsible university in the current situation by quoting something very interesting that I have read in the past weeks. There have been several analyses by McKinsey and many more by other companies, consultancies and analysts about the role of university and what should be done in an academic ground to overcome the crisis. But just I wanted to stress on these 4 bullets, which I have taken from the analysis about coronavirus and the campus. So 4 main roles of a university. The first one, bring an equity lens to every decision, meaning that with all the measures of taking everyone online, and this is valid, of course, not only for universities, but also for schools and high schools, we should not leave anyone behind. So people who don't have a proper connection or the technology to connect, we have to be sure that they're not left behind and we have to support them. It's great that the community in Bulgaria has reacted a lot about these issues. But in our university and faculty, if we have to quote something specific, for example, this was making sure that all the professors have the conditions and computers to connect with the students. So then we decided that even though we cannot meet in the university, we are going to be proactive and meet online with our community. The Faculty of Economics has been very active in the past decade with all the business events, with the integration of alumni in the educational process, and with bringing business closer with the students. And we have managed to do this in a way which I think was the best that was possible. The next one is thinking beyond your walls, meaning that strategic partnerships have to be established and developed. One of them is, of course, the partnership that brought us all together. We are very proud that the Faculty of Economics and UNICEF Bulgaria are going to be partnering more and more in the coming months with new initiatives related to the solidarity and responsibility in Bulgaria. And act with urgency, but with perspective. This is a difficult one because everything was so dynamic in the past 2 months. Not all the measures have been the best ones, but urgency was maybe the first priority in the beginning. Now we begin to see that we have to look a step or two further and prepare for the winter semester, if you wish, or for the next year, or for the economy, which is going to be quite different from now on. So just to give you some examples about our role in the community, of course, Sofia University, as an example, has been organizing the general response to the crisis. In the first place, of course, the health and safety measures for all staff and students. Even if the emergency situation is over, the university is going to remain closed until 25th of May for now, according to an order by the rector. And this is to ensure that the physical distancing can be observed for a longer period until we have more information about how all this is going to develop. Then the university managed to reorganize some of its processes and to take them entirely online. I say some because we still have some rules or legal hurdles that cannot make us entirely an online university. But believe us, we are doing some progress on this every day. Communicating with stakeholders and society. This is also something that the university has done through its researchers, professors, analysis that have been published in the past 2 months. I think this role of the university is a very important one in order to bring sanity into the conversation and to be able to discern from fake news and real analysis of what is happening. And of course, preparing for the future challenges, there will be official communication on how the university will be continuing with its admissions process and the examination session, etc., etc. We have done at the faculty some very interesting things, and we have done some very interesting solutions in the past 2 months. We have used virtually all the online systems that are available now for video conferencing or lectures. Some students like it because they get to know more systems. Some students and some professors do not like it because they have to be jumping from one platform to the other. But the message here is that we have done a lot into getting more digital in the past 2 months, and one of the positive effects of all this, of course, is that this will stay even after the crisis has finished. We have been following the employment situation very closely. A large part of our students and alumni work for FMCG and IT and outsourcing companies, banking sector and financial services, and virtually in all parts of the economy. So we have decided to go on with our career forum and take it entirely online with its supporting guest lectures. And we are trying to connect the people, the students, the alumni who have lost their jobs or who are looking for a first job to be able to connect with the companies which have been hiring and still need new talent even in this situation. I mentioned already that the university has outreached to partners and community, but the faculty has done so as well. In the economic field, we have been over the media with some analysis and with attempts to understand better what is going to be the economic situation in the next months and years. And you can see, of course, some screenshots of business events that took place online, from guest lectures to seminars and webinars that have been entirely taken online during the crisis. For example, today at 5 p.m. after this webinar, we start another one with the European Investment Bank and the Investment Fund. And of course, this event today and the event we organize with UNICEF next Monday is also in support of this. I just wanted to mention a few words about our partnership with UNICEF Bulgaria and to thank Ms. Jane Muita, Dr. Muita, for this opportunity. This is a picture you see on the screen of a gathering we had in mid-January this year with business leaders and UNICEF and the Faculty of Economics and Business Administration, starting an initiative to promote the rights of children through ethical business practices. And you can expect more news in the coming weeks about this partnership, which will basically establish a platform for exchanging knowledge, research through training modules and other initiatives. And I was very impressed with the leadership of Bulgarian business and the willingness of business leaders to be part of this process. So thank you, Marina. I hope that this has been good enough for the purpose of the meeting today. I'm ready to answer questions and participate in the discussion as well. Please let me thank again all the panelists who have joined us on the virtual grounds of the university today, as well as all the attendees who are listening to this webinar.